We are going to start unit number 3, illumination control and control circuits. In this lecture we will cover purpose of the lighting control, dimmers and different types of dimmers used for the illumination control. To turn on or turn off the lamp, we require lighting control. In some places we require different illumination level, and to obtain different illumination level we have to control the light energy output of the lamp, and in some places we require to save the electrical energy, and to save the electrical energy we have to control the illumination output from the lighting scheme as per desired. In commercial and industrial places, illumination level control is required. Also for the decoration purpose, we required different illumination level. For that, we required to design a lighting control circuit or illumination control circuit. Dimmers. We know that at rated voltage, any lamp radiates fixed amount of light energy. That is, if we give a rated voltage to the lamp, it will radiate rated luminous flux. Dimmer is a device to control the voltage applied to the lamp. Now this dimmer may be electrical or electronic device, and that is used to vary the light energy output of the lamp by controlling the input voltage of the lamp. So dimmer is a electrical or electronic device used to vary or control the light energy output of the lamp by controlling the input voltage of the lamp. See, in this figure, this dimmer, we give a fixed voltage to this dimmer, and the output of this dimmer is a variable voltage which will be the input for the lamp. As the output of dimmer varies, the light energy output of this lamp varies. Now these dimmers are of different types: variable resistance type dimmer, transformer type dimmer and electronic dimmers. In variable resistance type dimmer, we have resistance type dimmer and salt water type dimmer. In the transformer type dimmer, we have auto transformer dimmer and a two winding transformer dimmer. In electronic dimmers, we have thyristor operated dimmer and triac operated dimmer. Now let us see resistance type dimmer. Resistance type dimmer. In this dimmer, a variable resistance. See, this is a variable resistance. This variable resistance is connected in series with the lamp. This variable resistor is connected in series with the lamp. By varying the resistance, the voltage drop, voltage across the lamp can be varied. See, the lamp and resistors are in series. So in series circuit, whatever the voltage we have given, it get divides across these two elements. Therefore, more the resistance, more will be the voltage across resistance, lesser will be the voltage available across the lamp, and hence light energy output of the lamp can be controlled. So this is a resistance type dimmer. Second one dimmer is a salt water dimmer. This is also a resistance. This is also depends on a resistance. It consists of a moving electrode and fixed electrode. See, this is a moving electrode and this is a fixed electrode. Both electrodes are immersed in a salt water.
both electrodes are immersed in a salt water, and the salt water is placed in a insulated tank. Insulated tank means this tank is made up of non-electricity conducting material. Okay. Then this moving electrode is connected in series with the lamp, and the supply is given to this circuit. A fixed AC voltage supply is given to this circuit. Now see, as the distance between the moving electrode and fixed electrode increases, lesser current will be drawn from the supply, and that lesser current will result in less luminous output of the lamp, and vice versa. If we increase the distance of moving electrode from this fixed electrode, ultimately the resistance increases and lesser current will be drawn from the supply, and hence the luminous output of lamp is reduced. If you move closer to this fixed electrode, light output of lamp, luminous output of lamp increases. Next one is auto transformer dimmer. A simple auto transformer is used to control the light energy output of the lamp. Here the lamp is connected across the output of auto transformer, and to this auto transformer fixed AC voltage is given. So by varying the output of auto transformer, light energy output of the lamp is changed. Next is two winding transformer dimmer. This is a two winding transformer. On secondary sides, different tappings are available. So we can connect number of lamps on the secondary side of this two winding transformer. By selecting different taps, we can vary the voltage across the lamp. And hence the light output of the lamp. Next is thyristor operated dimmer. It is an electronic dimmer. See the circuit diagram. Thyristor or SCR is connected in series with the lamp, and here this R1, R2 and C, this is a circuit used to control the firing angle of the SCR. So thyristor is connected in series with the lamp. Resistance R1, R2 and capacitor is used to give gate pulse for conduction of SCR. Now see, for positive half cycle of AC voltage, this terminal is positive, this terminal is assumed to be negative. So what happened for positive half cycle? This SCR will be in forward bias, but this SCR will only conduct if gate pulse is given during forward biasing. The resistance R2 into C is the time constant for charging the capacitor. R2 into C, this value is the time constant, for charging the capacitor. Once the capacitor is charged, that get discharged, and it will fire the SCR, and SCR will starts conducting. Firing angle of SCR depends on value of R2 and C. That is, if you vary value of R2, the time constant changes, and according to that firing angle value changes, and if the firing angle value changes, the voltage applied across the lamp will change, and that will change the luminous output or light energy output of the lamp. But the disadvantage of this SCR type dimmer will be it will not conduct for negative half cycle. That is what happens. Though the capacitor will charge during negative half cycle also, but SCR will be in reverse bias during negative half cycle. Hence, SCR will not conduct even if we give gate pulse during negative cycle. Therefore, this is only half control, half wave control circuit. That is only during positive half cycle we can control the voltage applied to the lamp and hence luminous output. This disadvantage is overcome in thyristor operate. This disadvantage is overcome in triac operated dimmer. Triac is a two anti-parallel connected thyristors. This triac is connected in series with the lamp. This R2C2 circuit is used for firing the triac. The value of R2C2 decides the time of firing the triac. That is value of firing angle is decided by the value of R2C2, that is time constant of the charging of capacitor C2. Now, during positive half cycle of this supply voltage, this terminal is positive and this terminal is negative. The capacitor charge with this plate as positive, this plate as negative. Once this capacitor is charged to a voltage equal to forward breakover voltage of this diac, then this diac get turn on and the discharging of capacitor through this diac gives a positive gate pulse to this triac, and this triac, which is already forward bias due to positive half cycle, one of the thyristor is in forward bias. One of the thyristor of this triac is already in forward bias due to positive half cycle. Therefore, due to this gate pulse, this triac turns on, and depending on the value of firing angle due to this R2C2, a appropriate voltage appears across this lamp, and hence the output of light energy output of lamp is controlled. During negative half cycle, this terminal is positive and this terminal is negative. Therefore, this capacitor charged with this terminal positive and this terminal negative. Therefore, a gate pulse is given to this gate of the triac, and during negative half cycle, one of the thyristor of this triac is in forward bias. Therefore, triac turns on and current will flow in this direction. Appropriate voltage appears across this lamp, and hence lamp light energy output is controlled. That is, both positive half cycle and negative half cycles are controlled by the application of this triac, and this value of firing angles means this firing angle, larger will be the firing angle, lesser will be the voltage applied across the lamp. Smaller the firing angle, more the voltage is applied across the lamp. That is, by switching this triac with different firing angle, voltage across the lamp changes and hence the output of the lamp also changes.